Hi, welcome back to my channel. For this video, I am gonna tell you about my first long haul flight in business class. I'm so happy. And I'm gonna tell you how I got it for half the price. So if you're curious about that, keep watching and it will start in 3, 2, 1. All my travels since I started flying, I flew on economy class except for that one Croatia flight, but it's a domestic flight, it's just 1 hour, so it doesn't really count. There's not much difference either, so that doesn't count. So all my flights ever has always been on economy class, and every time you walk out the plane, you walk through the business class, and I feel like, oh, must be nice to have a bed for like a 16-hour flight. Must be nice. I don't know what else do we have. So there are things that we know, or at least I know, business class people get that economy doesn't. So I know the reclining chairs that turns into a bed, they have it, and a better toiletry bag. But aside from that, I know nothing about business class. So I was so surprised to see the other things that they actually offer there. Yeah, but before I do that, I'm gonna show you the toiletry bag difference. When I flew Philippine Airlines on business class versus the Philippine Airlines economy class, because I've always flown economy. And they always give this bag. I always take it. I bring it with me. I don't care. I have so much of these. And see, I have so much of these. I still take them with me. Who cares? Whatever. Judge me if you want. I don't really care. But so in this package, the economy, you should see it more. I can't. Taller. Wait. Okay, that's better. So on the economy class, this is the toiletry bag pouch that they give you. Is this it? Wait. Oh, I already opened this one. Let's open this new one. Okay, so this is their economy class toiletry bag. This has the bag. Toothbrush and a toothpaste. Like umbrella fabric eye mask. And long socks. That's it. That's what you get. With the business class, this is what you get. A leather pouch. It says Furla. So they probably partnered with Furla, although it feels nothing like Furla. But it has the Furla zipper too. So you can't see that anyway. And then here, I already took this out. I use it, okay. You have the eye mask, that's already dirty. The eye mask, which is a better fabric. And then socks. See, you know I saved this because it's still there. Socks. It's the same, I think. Oh no. This one's softer compared to this one. So like softer socks. Oh yeah. So they have Furla, partner with Philippine Airlines. They have Aka Kappa. Ooh, partnered with Philippine Airlines too. I don't know what that brand is. I'm not elite enough to know that brand. But the Aka Kappa is the brand for the lotion. Ooh, lotion. Lip balm. Ooh. Wait, do this. Yas. Lip balm. This is like all of this are sealed except for the eye mask as I used it. And then perfume. perfume, so everyone on business class probably smells the same. Ugh, there, perfume. And then come back here. Okay, there. And then you have a fancier toothbrush case with a bigger toothpaste. And the hairbrush. So you have more things on this pack compared to the economy class pack, and I probably would expect that. I did not record a lot of talking inside the plane because I was so shy and I feel like they're gonna judge me because, you know, this is my first time and I'm scared. So I'm just gonna explain it now and then show you the videos later. So when you come in, they actually offer you a welcome drink. It's juice and or water. That's how she said it. Hi ma'am, welcome to your flight. What do you want for your drink? Juice and or water. So you can take both. I did not because I don't like water. If you know me, you know that. And the juice they offered was Four Seasons, so I don't like Four Seasons either. So I skipped that part, and then they would actually introduce themselves. Another person came to me and said, hi, I forgot her name, sorry, let's just say Angel. Hi, I'm Angel, I'll be assisting you for your flight today, and if you need anything, just call me with this button, whatever. And then she would ask what you want, like what drinks would you want after we take off. So there's another drink there, so I just said tea. And you can see it on the video later that I was served tea immediately after like flying altitude is reached, you know, when it's after takeoff. Which is a nice thing because flying economy, I get so hungry after takeoff, and you have to wait until they actually start serving food, and you're in the middle of the plane, so you have to wait for everyone in front of you to get served before you do. But on business class, the moment that seatbelt sign was off, food was served. It was so fast, so it was so amazing. And the chair, the reclining chair, actually is a massage chair. I did not expect that at all. So it does the vibration thing. It was so fun. But yeah, like I said, I have a couple clips and I'm gonna show you my experience. And you can tell that I was really looking for someone to talk to and share the experience with, but I have no one. So I was just talking to the camera with like eyebrows, and you can see from my face I was so amazed from like about some things. So I'm just gonna show you the clips, and I'm gonna tell you afterwards how I got it for half the price, so you can do it yourself too. But yeah, enjoy the clips for now.
Lesson part B. My heart just got stuck between these loops.
So that's my whole experience, and I just told myself I should at least experience it once. And would I do it again? Depends on the price, or I don't know, depends on how much money I'll be making in the future. But did I like it? Yes, but I guess I had expectations that were not met. The bed, the sleeping is amazing. It's the best sleep I've ever had on a plane. You know, that one whole sleep where you just wake up for food and to change your clothes and that's it. Because on economy class, I wake up, watch movies, because I really can't, you know, you can't move so much on a chair. Food-wise, I guess I was expecting for either better food choices or food options, but it's the same food, it's the same taste, I think. There's not much difference there. With all that said, will I pay full price for it? No, definitely not. I told myself I will never pay for full price on a business class seat because it's just too much. So why did I decide to upgrade into business class? Because remember my previous flight, I got economy flex seats, which is $1,200, which is around 60,000 pesos. And 60,000? Yes, that's true. 60,000 pesos for economy flex. So all you get is the same economy experience, just with socially distanced seats and unlimited rebooking. So I actually just bought it for the socially distance seats because I want to be safe and all that. But it's $1,200. If you get the premium economy, which is a bigger seat that has more leg room, it's $1,700, which is 85,000 pesos. And then business class, I'm gonna put the screenshots here somewhere. Business class is $3,700. That is 185,000 pesos. I will never pay for that. Never. Not full price. Never. That's just too much. No. And this is one way, guys. One way from Davao to Manila to LA. But I got it for the one, for this experience, I got it for $1,500, which is like 75,000 pesos. So if you think about it, economy flex, the one I paid for before, is 1,200, 60,000. What I paid for now is 1,500, 75,000 pesos. $300 difference, which is 15,000 pesos. And I went from economy to business class. And it's even cheaper than the premium economy. It's less than half of the full price of the business class. So I thought, yes, it is a good deal already because I still wanted the socially distanced seats and they don't offer it anymore. They offer this new thing where you can buy an empty seat next to you and it's like $200 each. So I did the math, I decided on it, and then I decided to upgrade. So how do you upgrade? So I got the cheapest economy, like economy saver. I got that, it's $800. And then I think a week before your flight, they will send you an email offering this Mabuhay upgrade package. And then I just clicked on it, and then it will take you to a website. And then there's a scroller. What do you call that thing? It's a scroller. And it goes from zero to I don't know how much, I didn't even look. But the first amount that came up after zero was 35,000, which is like $700. Yes, my math is right. I can feel it. But the first movement from zero, the slightest movement on that scroller takes you to 35,000 pesos, which is about $700. And I'm like, it has a meter on the side that says you have poor chances of getting upgraded or like better chances. It was there on the really poor red part of the meter. But I didn't care. I just wanted to try it. And then I think 2 days after, I got an email saying, congratulations, you have upgraded to the business class. I'm like, oh my gosh, is this for real? And then I checked all the, I checked my ticket, how much I got it for, and then how much I actually paid extra for. And that's when I realized it's 1500 and it's even less than premium economy. So I think I did a good job. I spent $700 more, but still, I did not just have socially distanced seats. I had welcome drinks. I had the bed, crazy amazing bed. So will I do it again? Upgrade? Maybe. We'll see. Will I pay full price? No, because I already got it for half the price, even less. And why would I ever pay full price for something I know I could get for lesser amount? So I'm just sharing that to you, so in case you want to experience it for yourself too, you can. There's other ways to do it aside from saving up for the full price. So yeah, that is all. I hope I can see everyone on business class next time, like posting stuff like, yay, I got it for half the price too, thanks to Angel. If you want to share this information to people so you can go travel business class together, then go share the video. And if you like it, press the like button and don't forget to subscribe to my channel, and I'll see you again next week. Bye.